The Techies are truly the purest form of chaotic evil in all of Dota. Using the power of mind games, a Techies player can systematically tear apart the foundations of your mental fibers as the entire map becomes an explosive death trap. While you may not always win, you can take solace in the fact that you actively pissed off 9 other players in your game. Don't worry, this episode won't last 80 minutes, even though we are talking about the history of Techies. Squee, Spleen, and Spoon are ranged intelligence heroes who specialize in defensive strategies by blanketing the map with an assortment of mines. Their first skill is proximity mines, which plants an invisible mine that deals a large amount of magic damage upon detonating. Mines will reveal themselves when an enemy gets too close and will blow up after a small delay. In this small window, enemies can attack the mines and gain a moderate amount of bounty for their troubles. The mines will not be revealed with True Sight and can damage buildings for a fraction of their normal damage. Stasis Trap plants an invisible trap that roots nearby enemies when triggered. Unlike proximity mines, this will activate immediately and can be revealed through True Sight. Blast Off allows Techies to launch themselves to a target location, dealing damage and silencing enemies where they land. This also causes them to take damage equal to 50% of their max health, meaning that you can use this skill to deny yourself in case things get a bit too sticky. Remote Mines is the Techies' ultimate ability, letting them plant a mine that they can activate whenever they feel like it. The Remote Mines last for a set amount of time before expiring, and will only explode when either Focus Detonate or Pinpoint Detonate set them off. The Techies also come with an innate ability called Minefield Sign, which plants a warning sign into the ground, notifying the enemy team that you're around to cause mischief, but functionally, doesn't really do anything. That is, unless you pick up an Aghanim Scepter, which causes a small area around the sign to completely conceal any mines or traps you may have out, even if the enemy team has detection. In other words, your enemies will have to sacrifice someone if they want to push into the high ground. The Techies first bombarded Dota on April 8th, 2004 in patch 4.0. In their initial offering to the world, they were actually known as the Goblin Techies and were described as a sneaky ranged hero, adept with technologies. Not soon after, in 4.1, there is a slight addendum, adding that you should be wary when choosing him as his gameplay is very unique. 6.04 gave the Techies their first real piece of lore, explaining that they're a force to be reckoned with due to their ability to lay mines in the earth, invisible to the naked eye. Due to their involvement with Orcish Voodoo Priests of Kalimdor, they are also able to plant paralysis-inducing traps, referring to the stasis traps, which use a much more primal model. You'll also notice here that their names are Squee and Spleen, with Spoon seemingly absent from the group. A Reddit user by the name of Yertle the Turtle revealed some insight regarding this mystery. For the longest time, people weren't aware that the barrel running alongside the two visible goblins was in fact a third goblin. In 2006, Yertle the Turtle pointed this out and proposed a list of names for the third goblin, with Spoon winning the vote. According to the man himself, the other names he suggested included Yertle, Spree, and Spork. Spoon had led the poll so much that the suggestion came down to a simple question: should we name the third goblin Spoon? 2 years later, in version 6.58, the name was finally implemented, with the original forum post being referenced in the patch notes. Before I get into the nitty-gritty, I just wanted to point out the excellent voice acting from this unit, whose personality really shines through in all of these responses.
For all my homies! What's happening? That'll be a blast! Do not run! We are your friends!
Their first set of skills also differed from what we have now. Formerly, the Techies' first skill was known as Landmines, which could be placed and hidden indefinitely, dealing its damage once any enemy unit walks over it. Stasis Trap was more or less the same, although you got stunned instead of rooted, and if you got caught, you might as well do some push-ups or something because you're gonna be stuck for a while. Techies also started with a passive ability called Explosive Shot, which added a small amount of splash damage to their auto attacks. Their ultimate here is called Suicide Squad Attack, which turns the Techies into a bomb, probably through the use of Killer Queen. In 4.1, Explosive Shot was changed to instead increase damage and range of your auto attacks, giving them some much needed right click damage. In 5.1, Explosive Shot was replaced altogether by Rapid Revive, which passively decreased your death timer by a certain percentage per level. In 5.71, Rapid Revive was then replaced by Suicide Squad Attack, and Techies gained Remote Mines as their new ultimate ability. Instead of being able to activate the mines individually, you would have to do them all at once using the sub-ability Detonate, which actually costs 50 mana. With this change, Techies would exist in their most memorable and enduring skill set. With three types of mines and the ability to be tossed by Tinian for a kamikaze attack, the Techies were truly fury incarnate. 6.17 reduced stasis trap stun duration on non-hero units in order to match the duration for heroes. 6.37 had landmines provide vision in a small radius to make them visible on the minimap for allies. 6.41 made it so that remote mines no longer prevent neutral creeps from spawning, taking away some of their mid and late game threat as they couldn't mine up the jungle to mess with the opponent. Detonate's cooldown was also increased from 0 seconds to 1 second, which I guess is a nerf. Not that it matters if you detonate all your remote mines, but the patch notes mention that this was done to prevent some abuses. In 6.60, techies got their first taste of Aghanim's sweet, sweet scepter. This simply increased remote mine's damage and cast range, which is all fairly negligible, but the extra range allowed for much safer planting. In 6.68, remote mines started detonating when killed, making it particularly dangerous for melee heroes to disarm them. In 6.69, techies had their base attack damage increased from 2 to 4 to 7 to 9. In the grand scheme of things, not too huge, but that's a 233% increase in early game harass, and that is value. Remote mines also gain a new sub-ability called Focus Detonate, which is similar to what we have now. And because of this, the normal Detonate ability was renamed to Detonate All, just for some added clarity. 6.72 increased the landmine's max limit from 15 to 20, and made Suicide Squad attack give techies experience when they get a kill with it, reduces their respawn rate by 50%, and increased the cooldown on the ability by a huge margin. In this patch, Detonate All was also removed as a sub-ability, and the Aghanim Scepter cast range on remote mines was reduced. Thankfully for the rest of the world, techies were never explicitly ported to any other game. Although when I thought about all the hate and vitriol these little guys get, I couldn't help but notice how similar it all was to League of Legends' own Teemo. Of course, the only spell that Teemo has in common with the techies is Noxious Trap, which throws down an invisible mushroom that deals a magic damage burst, followed by a damage over time, and a slow. With a playstyle that goes against the norm, Teemo players regularly ruin team comps in favor of personal motivations. Also, look at that face. Just wanna punch the little bastard. For these reasons, I think if the techies ever needed a fourth member, they have an equally obnoxious ally in the Swift Scout. The techies erupted into Dota 2 on September 14th, 2014, and with them came a rush of salt and anticipation. They were first revealed to the public in the TI4 All-Star match, which took place in July of that year. Just as RTZ last picked Sniper, he switched over to the techies last second and was met with a quaking roar from the crowd along with a sick pyro display. He ended the game with 27 deaths. In their lore and characterization, the techies are a group of maniacs obsessed with causing explosions. Their story tells a time where they completely destroyed a place called Dredger's Bite, causing all of its residents to run away from the impact zone as their town crumbled into the mines below. Apparently, Squee and Spleen seem to think that Spoon died in an explosion a while back, alluding to the fact that most people were unaware that there was a third techies back in the Warcraft 3 days.
Spoon was in the workshop when it exploded, right?
I think so.
No, I wasn't.
You know, sometimes I can still hear his voice.
A number of their voice lines also reference other Valve games.
They're gonna have to glue you back together!
In hell!
Counter techies win! Continue testing!
Who said we couldn't count to three, huh?
On that note, the techies were all voiced by Dee Bradley Baker, whose line of work also included Perry the Platypus from Phineas and Ferb, the Dad from Cow and Chicken, and Olmec from The Legends of the Hidden Temple. This bit of information was just a thinly veiled excuse to draw this. Time well spent, if I do say so myself. On their release, techies also had an arcana set known as the Swine of the Sunken Galley that lets them use a cannon in their arsenal, simply known as the Swine. It gave the techies a strange pig-themed set, along with a courier called Nibolg the Mad that was designed after the techies themselves. Most notably, this set gave techies access to the minefield sign, which was exclusive to the set and not available without the item equipped. This sparked a debate among the various forums, citing that the item was granting extra access to mind games hidden behind a paywall, which could have led to a slippery slope of more items giving benefits to other heroes in the future. This was rectified on September 2nd, 2014, where minefield sign was added as an innate ability to techies. Since then, the techies have had a small number of changes, but they were all fairly significant. In 6.82, landmines had its damage type changed from composite to physical, and would no longer trigger or damage flying units such as Visage's Familiars or Beastmaster's Hawk. In 6.85, all three mines would no longer trigger when getting destroyed, giving melee heroes a taste of revenge. They could also be destroyed if targeted by a Quelling Blade or Battle Fury, and all provide a 10 gold bounty when killed. This was a giant nerf to the techies, as placing mines in the late game could potentially reward enemy heroes. However, landmines also had its max limit removed, meaning that, as a techies player, you could fill out the whole map with mines. With this change, the entire playing field can be your high ground. In 7.00, techies had a rework, and were naturally removed from Captain's Mode. These were all mentioned earlier, so I'll be brief. Landmines became proximity mines, becoming undetectable, and detonate after a brief delay when an enemy comes near the mine. Stasis Trap now roots enemies rather than stunning them, and they detonate instantly. Suicide Squad Attack was replaced by Blast Off, only dealing half of Techie's max health, and silencing enemies caught by the spell. Remote Mines also gained a tiny detonation delay, and its cast time was reduced by a small amount. Techie's first set of talents were among the boring kind, although they do help the hero at all stages of the game. In 7.05, proximity mines were given a sound effect when they appear, making them more apparent when they pop up. In 7.06, in an attempt to replace all of their respawn talents, Techies gained a 250 attack damage bonus on one of their level 25 talents. The Techies already have the longest attack range in the game, so they could be a really potent late game carry, turning their auto attacks into small nukes. In 7.07, Techies gained a game-changing talent in that all mines could gain 25 movement speed, meaning that they can actually slowly inch toward the enemy ancient in a sluggish avalanche of death. If you succeed with this strategy, you'll achieve one of the funniest win conditions in all of Dota, and might have a moment on Dota WTF while you're at it. In addition to this, their right side talent went from 250 attack damage to 251, because it's funny. Dota doesn't have to be all about tryharding, you know. In 7.14, Techies were added back into Captain's mode, over a year after they were removed due to their rework. Finally, in 7.15, their base attack damage was increased to 911, and I wouldn't have it any other way. Choosing Techies is a lot like wiping your hands on a baby. It's going to piss a lot of people off, but who's gonna stop ya? If you ever needed to release your stress after a long day of work, you can always count on Techies to be there to shut off your brain and cause havoc for hours and hours and hours. I'm Dennis Atal, and that was the history of Techies. I can't stress this enough. Thank you so much, Yertle, for responding to my messages about the whole Techies naming thing. Getting a first-hand account is really difficult, but you were incredibly helpful and responsive. Keeping up my end, Yertle has a very simple message for everyone out there. Be positive, help others in need, always keep learning and improving. Also, Aburon, stop playing Dota. With that, follow me on Twitter, check out the Patreon, and be sure to chat with me in the comments. Take care now.